Junito Hamada is here. You might recognize him from, oh, I don't know, Homeland, American Sniper, so many cool things. How are you?
I'm very well. Thank you for having me.
Thank you for coming in.
Yes.
So tell me what the latest project is. It's something that got me really excited.
Yes, the latest project I'm doing is Veronica Mars.
So the TV show Veronica Mars?
Yes, the exact one. They're doing a reboot. Hulu is doing a reboot of Veronica Mars. And it's with Kristen Bell, Jason Doring, and Enrico Colatoni. They're all still in it. And it's going to be fantastic. The guest stars in it are amazing, myself included. Yeah. Not amazing, just the guest star. But it's going to be fantastic. That's, it really is.
That's awesome. You know what? I want to talk a little bit about the way Hollywood is transitioning to these Amazon Primes and
yes,
Hulu.
Yes.
What is it? Is it different for you as an actor, or is it is there a stigma to it if it's not on broadcasting and not on the big screen?
To be honest with you, I might be hurting myself here, but I prefer the streamers and I prefer the new networks that are working and the things that are coming up because there seems to be less censorship. Mm-hmm. And I think that the writing is phenomenal. Yeah. I think the shows that we are now seeing, I think this is the golden age of TV.
Tell me about parts for actors these days. I mean, you're from the UK.
Well, I'm actually from Egypt.
I was gonna say, so you grew up in the UK, but
no, I grew up in Germany.
Okay, so you grew up in Germany,
Egyptian,
up in Germany, and then was living in the UK.
Yes.
So now that you're here and you came to the US because the US came calling for
Absolutely,
you to be an
yes.
actor here, what is that like? Because, you know, we hear these stories and actors from actors saying, you know, there's a bias, there's a hardship in getting parts for people who are not
white
and American, right?
All that is true and all that is changing.
Tell me why.
So I think, first of all, yes, it is true. I think people in the business want to make money first and foremost. That's the main thing, I think. We want to tell stories, but we also want to make money. And they think, or there's some belief, that you can only make money with a certain type of face. Because the world as a whole has gotten used to seeing a certain type of face and is very accepting of that particular type of face and not of any others. Mm-hmm. So the people that are in the money and that have the money and that can create these shows, they have to be convinced that you can make money off people like me, of people like that are Hispanic or people from Indonesia or people from Asia. It doesn't matter where you're from, mm-hmm. that you can make money with everyone's face because the world is getting wider, it's getting more open.
Yes.
And if you think of places like Netflix and Amazon, they're doing those things exactly. They're bringing in international talent from all over the world and creating a small world.
Mm-hmm.
And I think the world has gotten smaller. And
mm-hmm.
I think that's why things are shifting. And I think the Me Too movement has been incredible. So just to say something, so I just finished shooting Veronica Mars.
Yes.
It's the first time in my career that I've worked, half the directors on the episodes were female.
And
that is the first time that's ever happened.
Well,
for me.
I mean, it's shocking to hear that.
Yeah.
But it's not shocking to know where we started from.
Exactly.
Absolutely. So how do we keep convincing people that money can be made when a face looks different?
Do you know, I think it's for people like myself and others to create their own stories and to go to people and to say, these are the stories that we'd like to tell. Why don't you tell this story? And then I think you have a chance. When you have people in the decision-making places, so not just actors, so, you know, I'm an actor, but we need people that look like me and look like other people in positions as writers, as producers, heads of networks, heads of studios, heads of everything. And if you have that, everything changes.
FYI, it does sell.
Yes, of course.
When things look different. Look
of
at
course.
Crazy Rich Asians. Look
yes.
at everything that happens.
Yes.
You know, these types of things.
Black Panther
100%.
is a perfect example of how Black culture was celebrated. You have not just Black actors, but a Black director and Black costume designer and African American.
Yeah, yeah.
And all that makes a huge difference.
Wonder
it makes
Woman.
A wonderful,
all women, all
women.
Females, right?
Absolutely.
Patty Jenkins, Gal Gadot. I mean, come on.
I can't tell you how much fun I had shooting Veronica Mars and having three women directing.
What was the difference? I mean, tell me, because you've been an actor for many years, so what is the difference? I mean, yes, females have a different perspective, right?
Mm-hmm.
But what does that look like versus when men direct for you as the actor?
I think it just depends on what the person brings and how comfortable they are in their own skin.
Mm-hmm.
And I think I always feel most comfortable with a director that's comfortable in their own skin and who they are. So if you're not trying to make up and compensate for being a female on set, everything's going to be 100%. If you're trying to compensate, then things become more difficult. But I think I didn't experience any of that in the last couple of years. It's been absolutely amazing.
That is amazing. So let's hope that continues.
Yes, please.
And then now that Veronica Mars is wrapped and you can't share with me who the cool guest stars are, unfortunately, who do you play in the series?
I play a character called Daniel Maloof. He's an American Arab American congressman. That in itself is already something, right?
I was just gonna say, there you go.
So there we go. So I'm playing an Arab,
you.
I am playing an Arab American congressman who gets into a bit of trouble.
Oh boy.
And so lots of events occur that he has to respond to.
Okay.
And so we'll see how that all turns out.
How it all plays out.
Kristen Bell is just phenomenal.
Yeah,
she is an absolute star. She is so wonderful, so warm. One of the best sets I've ever been able to be privy to. It's fantastic.
All right. Well, we will be seeing you in Veronica Mars. And then whatever's next, please stop by and tell us.
Will do.
All right.
Will do.
Thank you for coming in.
Thank you.
Great conversation.
Yes, thank you.